Hello everyone, my name is Labrini Papafoti. I am a future transport officer at Transport for West Midlands. My presentation is about the mobility credits concept and specifically about lessons from the Coventry Mobility Credits Trial. I would like to start with an overview of this trial. The Mobility Credits Trial is part of the UK Department for Transport funded Future Transport Zone programme. This program involves the testing of various new mobility technologies and services in the West Midlands. The Mobility Credits Trial is a car scrapper scheme that allows participants to exchange high polluting cars for £3,000 of mobility credits. The mobility credits can be used to pay for a range of transport services, public transport and other transport services, as I will explain to you shortly. It takes place in an area of Coventry, which is located in the West Midlands of the UK. The trial area was selected because of high levels of air pollution. Beyond this, though, other criteria such as the availability of public transport and new mobility services were also taken into consideration. Coventry residents could sign up for this trial between March 2021 and March 2022. In total, 99 people signed up for the trial and exchanged the car for mobility credits. So why is this trial innovative and how does it differ from traditional car scrapper schemes? Traditional car scrapper schemes are schemes that aim to replace older cars with newer, more efficient, less polluting cars, for example with electric cars. Their aim is to reduce emissions of an area without necessarily encouraging the use of more sustainable transport modes or reducing the number of cars within an area. A car scrappers with mobility credits scheme, as the trial which is taking place in Coventry, is concerned with the replacement of older cars with mobility credits. By mobility credits here, I mean a dedicated budget that can be used to cover expenses for public transport and other sustainable transport options. The aims of these schemes, therefore, differ from those of traditional car scrapper schemes. Mobility credits provide an opportunity to trigger travel behavioral change. Their main aim is to encourage a mode shift from private car to more sustainable modes. Now, turning back to our Coventry Mobility Credits trial, this slide shows the four objectives for this. As this was an innovative project, the first objective was to demonstrate the design and application of a mobility credit scheme that can also be adjusted to different local area needs. The second and the third objectives here relate to the evaluation research program that is being carried out for this trial. This program involves research activities with the participants that signed up for the scheme. Through these research activities, therefore, we want to improve our understanding of the benefits of mobility credit schemes for citizens and to understand also the barriers to adoption. We also want to understand the impact of mobility credits on attitudes towards car ownership and use and how it affects also the travel behavior of our participants. The final objective, the fourth objective, is to remove older, highly polluting vehicles from the road. We also want to contribute to some improvements in air quality within the trial area. Moving on now to the mobility credits offer, with this slide I would like to present to you the types of transport modes and services that the mobility credits participants can choose from and pay for with their credits. Through early engagement with Coventry citizens, we understood that we needed to enable payments towards various transport services to incentivize people to get rid of their cars for mobility credits. For this reason, we enabled payments towards buses, trains and trams, car club and car rental options, bike sharing, shared scooters, taxis and ride hailing, and more recently we also enabled purchases of bikes, e-bikes and cycling accessories. In terms of the financial incentive and the payment mechanism, each of our participants was offered £3,000 of mobility credits in exchange for an older car. Each participant can use the credits to pay for their own travel and the household's travel needs. The credits were offered in the form of a prepaid debit card that can be used to buy tickets and pay for all of the transport service that I mentioned to you before. As far as the cycling purchases are concerned, so the purchases of bikes, e-bikes and cycling accessories, participants could request vouchers that can be redeemed at selected cycle stores. I would like now to present to you how our participants perceive the trial and the benefits of mobility credits for themselves. These are some preliminary findings from research interviews with mobility credits participants. Our participants first perceive that the scheme has given them the opportunity to try alternative to private car transport services. They also perceive that the scheme has a financial benefit. The financial incentive, the £3,000 financial incentive, is considered good value for money as it is frequently higher than the value of their car. And their participation in the trial has allowed them to reduce their cost of travel. Finally, as expected, they also believe that there is an environmental benefit from removing high polluting cars from the road. Finally, I would like to conclude this presentation with some recommendations for the development of future mobility credit schemes. To design and implement similar trials and schemes, transport policymakers would need to assess. First, what modes and services need to be included in the offer. Second, the amount of credits required to incentivize car users to replace their cars with mobility credits. Third, they may want to consider if the scheme should target and prioritize specific social groups that experience transport affordability issues. Four, and depending on the context and availability of integrated payment solutions, transport policymakers will need to define the payment mechanism. This can be a simple card, as in this trial, or a mobility as a service application. To approach these questions and make these decisions, it is important to consider first the policy and strategic objectives, so what we want to achieve with these projects. Second, the availability, accessibility and coverage of public transport in the scheme area. And third, it is critical to engage with the public at the early stages of the development of such projects to understand the needs of citizens and how to develop successful mobility credit schemes. Thank you very much for your attention. I hope you found the content of this presentation informative and useful.